Good morning, VKids! We are so glad to have you with us this morning as we continue our journey through the Psalms. And this morning we're learning all about Psalm 91, which is about being hidden under the shadow of God's wings. And I know that might sound a little strange, but here's an illustration that helps me. When it's raining, a mother duck will hide her chicks under her wing to protect them from the rain so they don't get wet, even though they swim. But it's just a symbol of the mother's love for her chicks, that she wants to protect them when there's a storm. So just like storms in our life, God wants to hide us under the shadow of his wing, and that's where we can find comfort, protection, and safety. Let's head over to Kate's Comedy Corner to get some laughs this morning before we get into our lessons. Good morning, VKids. It's the latest, the greatest, the best comedian in all of Santa Monica, Kate, your very own VKids comedian. So, for our first joke today, what do you call a cow in an earthquake? A milkshake. For the next one, what vegetable did Noah not want on the ark? Leeks. All right, let's see if Granny Pasterner is making her famous leek pea soup.
Oh, who've we got there? I wonder if it could be the VKids. Let me just put my spectacles on. Oh dear, my pearls are all stuck in. Oh no. Oh, hello, it's the VKids. So lovely to see you all. Now, I've heard today you're learning all about Psalm 91, which is a wonderful psalm all about how we can be safe under God's wings. And I know Miss Amanda was telling you a little bit about how when chicks are safe under their mother's wings. Now, I'm going to read you a little bit from this lovely book by Sally Lloyd-Jones. It's called Thoughts to Make Your Heart Sing. And this is what it says about being safe under his wings. Have you ever been afraid? Do what baby chicks do. At the first sign of danger, if there's a storm coming or a hawk hovering, a mother hen spreads out her wings and clucks to her babies, and they run straight under her feathers. The mother draws her wings in tight, tucking every one of her little chicks safely under her. Nothing can touch those babies. And we have a Heavenly Father who says he loves us and cares for us just like that. When we are afraid, he tells us to run to him. We can nestle up under his wings and he will protect us. So VKids, it actually says in the psalm, Psalm 91, it says, he will cover you with his feathers and under his wings you will find refuge. Wonderful. And you know, that reminds me of a story about how the disciples were with Jesus in a storm and they were afraid, but Jesus calmed the storm. So let's all watch that story together now.
The Captain of the Storm. The sun was going down. The air was warm and still. "Let's go across the lake," Jesus said to his friends. Jesus had been helping people all day, and now he was tired. So they left the crowds at the shore and set out in a small fishing boat. Jesus climbed into the boat to take a nap. As soon as his head touched the pillow, he fell fast asleep. It was a beautiful evening. A gentle breeze rustled the sails. The friends were chatting happily as they headed out into the middle of the lake. Everything was perfect, just right for a nice, quiet sail. They were only about halfway across when, out of nowhere, Whirling winds swept across the lake, fierce and strong like a hurricane. A blinding flash of lightning lit up the sky. Thunder roared right overhead. The storm blew the water into towering waves that hurled the little boat up, 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 and then sent it hurtling, crashing back down, down, down. The fishing boat was blown and buffeted and tossed and turned back and forth, up and down, left and right, round and round. And in the middle of the storm, Jesus was sleeping. Now, Jesus' friends had been fishermen all their lives, but in all their years fishing on this lake, they had never once seen a storm like this one. No matter how hard they struggled with their ropes and sails, they couldn't control their boat. This storm was too big for them. But the storm wasn't too big for Jesus. "Help!" they screamed. "Wake up! Quick, Jesus!" Jesus opened his eyes. "Rescue us! Save us!" they shrieked. "Don't you care?" Of course Jesus cared. And this was the very reason he had come, to rescue them and to save them. Jesus stood up and spoke to the storm. "Hush," he said. That's all. And the strangest thing happened. The wind and the waves recognized Jesus' voice. Well, they had heard it before, of course. It was the same voice that made them in the very beginning. They listened to Jesus, and they did what he said. Immediately, the wind stopped, the water calmed down. It glittered innocently in the moonlight and lapped quietly against the side of the boat as if nothing had happened. The little boat bobbed gently up and down. There was a deep stillness and a great quiet all around. Then Jesus turned to his wind-torn friends. "Why were you scared?" he asked. "Did you forget who I am? Did you believe your fears instead of me?" Jesus' friends were quiet as the wind and the waves, and into their hearts came a different kind of storm. "What kind of man is this?" they asked themselves anxiously. "Even the winds and the waves obey him," they said, because they didn't understand. They didn't realize yet that Jesus was the Son of God. Jesus' friends had been so afraid they had only seen the big waves. They had forgotten that if Jesus was with them, then they had nothing to be afraid of, no matter how small their boat or how big the storm.
Well, VKids, I love that story about how Jesus calms the storm, how he spoke to the wind and the waves. Now, I know someone else who knows a bit about weather, and that's my good friend, Sunny Day. Let's head over to the VKids newsroom and see if he can update us on the weather in Los Angeles. Good morning, VKids. It's Anchorwoman Amy, anchored in Christ, bringing you the live breaking news on the epic storm brewing in Los Angeles, California. And we have our own legendary weatherman, Sunny Day, live to report. Over to you, Sunny.
Yeah, hi there, Amy. Yes, Sunny Day here in the eye of the storm right now. It's getting a bit wet and windy, so gonna need to wear my shower cap. Back to you.
And Sunny, how are you staying so calm, so fearless in the midst of such an epic storm?
Well, that's a real great question there, Amy. That's because, you know, I have a faith in Jesus, and I know even when things are a bit stormy that actually he's gonna real look after me because he's my savior.
Wow, what an encouragement this morning from our very own Sunny Day. And VKids, when we have Jesus with us, we don't need to be afraid. We don't need to fear because he can give us his peace that passes all understanding. He can speak to the wind and the waves, "Peace be still," and can do that to our hearts and our minds. That makes my heart happy. I feel a worship coming on. Well, VKids, I am sure glad that Sunny Day has Jesus in his life to anchor him in the storm. That looked like a wild storm he was in, and he stayed so calm because he is connected to Jesus. Now let's go over to our friend Hamilton and see if he has our memory verse that can remind us about the Psalm 91 that we've been learning about today.
Good morning, VKids. It's me, Hamilton T. Hedgehog, with you again for another memory verse. Now, I know you've been learning today about Psalm 91 and what it means to be safe under his wings. So, we're going to learn a verse from that. So, it's Psalm 91, verse 4. And it says, "He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge." So how about learning that and encouraging others with that this week and maybe showing them Psalm 91 in your Bible? So I'll see you very soon. Bye!
VKids, I've been loving the new worship song, Jericho, about the walls coming tumbling down. Let's head over to Australia for a worship warm-up by Jenny Jogslot before we get into our worship song this morning.
Hey guys, Jenny Jogslot just out here in Melbourne, Australia. Now we're going to do our Jericho song today. So let's go through some of the actions. Do you remember it went, "Our God, he will tear down the walls. Our God, he is invincible," where we do our superhero pose. That's it. "Strongholds crumble like castles of sand as we shout loud our Jericho song." Amazing job, you guys. But before we go into it, let's do our warm up. We're going to do our 10 jumping jacks. You ready? Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Amazing job. Let's all worship together.
Set us free. Your mighty name will ever be the soundtrack of our victory. We're lifting up your praise like a battle cry. The thunder of your name breaks apart the night. Your matchless grace will ever be the soundtrack of our victory.
Well, VKids, it's been another incredible morning as we continue to journey through the Psalms. Remember Psalm 91 this week about how you are hidden under the shadow of His wings. Jesus will always be your protector. Have a blessed week, and we look forward to seeing you next Sunday. I'm not afraid to